Very good morning to all the children. 14 students have joined and 3 are present in the class. So where are rest of the students? Beta, kindly those who have joined today also, there are some students who have started taking classes very casually. Fine, don't think that being science students you will avoid physical education, computer or English. It will affect your marks at the end of the day. So kindly, you have to be regular. Those who are absent, they will be answerable to me later on. I'll be sending them personal messages then. So let's start without wasting much time. We are going to start with the new chapter, the summer of the beautiful white horse, chapter number 1 of snapshots. Okay. Firstly, let me introduce the characters of this chapter. Aram and Murad. It's a fine name. Murad also you can say, but Murad is the exact pronunciation, fine? So Aram and Murad both are Armenian boys hailing from Armenia, fine? And they are cousins. And then we'll read about one uncle, Khosrov. He is uncle of Aram and Murad only. And later on, whenever he will be coming into the chapter, then we will discuss his character. So let me tell you firstly about Aram and Murad, a bit of the information. So the chapter will be starting, why the name of the chapter is Summer of Beautiful White Horse? Because the chapter starts where Murad will be bringing a beautiful white horse. He's riding that horse and he will be knocking at the window of his house or of his cousin's room, especially Aram. And it was early in the morning. Dawn period, D-A-W-N, early morning. And Aram was sleeping obviously at that time. And when he opened the window, he could not believe what he saw. He saw Murad sitting on a beautiful white horse. And he started rubbing his eyes as if it was a dream or reality. Fine, he never in his dreams thought that his cousin would be bringing beautiful white horse. And he asked him to join him for the riding. So this is the beginning of the chapter. I won't be telling you rest of the part now. Clear? So you got the name of the chapter is the Summer of Beautiful White Horse. Then background. This tribe, actually people of Armenia, there are many various tribes in Armenia. You know, people, they start forming particular groups, you can say, in their societies, the way we have segregated our society. So, you know, small tribes, they were living. So they belong to Armenian tribe and Gargolian family. Fine. You might have heard that he's Rajasthani, he's Marwadi, he's Punjabi, he's in that way. Fine. So they belong to that tribe and they are known as the people of Gargolian family, Gargolian tribe. It is the name of the tribe only. Clear? So Gargolian is one of the tribe of Armenia. Is it clear to you? Fine. And why that tribe is famous, that Gargolian family is famous for their honesty. And not from the last few days or years, since centuries. You know, it runs in the family of Gargolian people that they are honest only. They can never steal. They can never tell a lie. They can never ditch a person. Fine. They never hurt the feelings of others, you can say. So they're very honest in their approach, whether they get lesser or more to eat, but they are the last person on this earth to steal. Got my point? So they are known for their honesty and truthfulness, you can say. They're very honest and true people, and nobody in their tribe has done such any act of stealing or any which is not true or which is not honest. Dishonesty is not in their tribe. Clear? So they are famous for this. This trait or this, you can say, quality. Clear? The background is clear. Characters are clear. Uncle Khosrow will be later on coming. Fine. Now, when we, even brothers, sisters, they are not same. They are not alike. When you compare yourself with your brother or sister, you have some other approach. You can have some other idea. Your brother or sister can. Sometimes, you know, parents start comparing also. See, your brother speaks so well. How are you talking to me? Sometimes they say, okay, see, look at your brother. You know, he's He gets angry at everything. Look at your sister. She's very good. She does not, you know, start showing anger in that way. So some people are angry. Some people are very having patience. Some are very sweet. Some very, you can say, some people, they put forth their point in a very nice way. Some are very harsh while talking. So these are the inborn qualities of everyone. Each person is, each individual is different. So when we talk about Aram and Murad, they are also obviously different in approach. So there is no much age difference is not there. Exact age we will be reading. They are teenagers only, 11, 12, 13 or 9 and 10. Fine. So we will be reading the about the exact age in the chapter. Let me tell you more about Aram and Murad. Murad is very, you can say, outgoing persona. Fine. He does not hesitate of doing anything. He is ready to take chances in life. Aram, on the other hand, is again blind follower of the family lineage. What is their family lineage? To be honest, to be truthful, to be good always. So Aram is the follower of that. But Murad has a kind of crazy streak in him. Fine, he is a bit different. So he is coming on a beautiful white horse. And they belong to such a poor tribe, such a poor family and poor background. They cannot even imagine to have such a beautiful white horse. Now you got my point? That how come Murad comes on a beautiful white horse early in the morning, which is very odd time, and knocked at the window of Aram. So Aram is now hesitant of how come he's having a horse. So let's find out what is the reality. Is it clear to you all, beta? Any doubt? Fine. So I'll be sharing the screen with you all. If you have noted down these things, let's start with the chapter. Summer of the Beautiful White Horse by William Saroyan. One day back, I'm going to read from here. Yes, this story is about two poor Armenian boys who belong to a tribe whose hallmarks are trust and honesty. Underline, this is the important question. What are the hallmarks of Gargolian tribe? Why the tribe was famous? Fine. What they have been following since years or centuries. So this is the hallmark since centuries. I'm not saying years. See, fine. So Summer of the Beautiful White Horse, stories about two poor Armenian boys who belong to a tribe whose hallmarks are trust and honesty. One day back there in the good old days when I was 9 and world was full of every imaginable kind of magnificence and life was still a delightful and mysterious dream, my cousin Murad was, who was considered crazy, underline this, that Murad was considered crazy. So what is the age of Aram now? 9. Fine. Underline the very first line they have told, that when Aram was 9 and world was full of every imaginable kind of magnificence, life was still a delightful and mysterious dream. My cousin Murad, who was considered crazy by everyone who knew him except me, came to my house at 4 in the morning and woke me up tapping on the window of my room. So that was quite shocking for Aram, who is 9-year-old boy, that his cousin Murad, he's tapping at the window at 4 o'clock in the morning. Aram, he said, I jumped out of the bed and looked out of the window. I couldn't believe what I saw. It was not morning yet, but it was summer and with daybreak, not many minutes around the corner of the world, it was light enough for me to know I was not dreaming. So during the summer, you know that early morning period, it is visibility is there at least. So he was able to perceive that his cousin Aram was standing outside the window. But he could not believe what he saw. What did he see? It wasn't, my cousin Murad was sitting on a beautiful white horse. I stuck my head out of the window and rubbed my eyes. Why did he rub his eyes? because he could not believe what he saw. It's not because he got up from the sleep. Fine. So he just started rubbing his eyes because whatever he was seeing, that his cousin was sitting on a beautiful white horse, he could not believe it. So that's why he rubbed his eyes. Yes, he said in Armenian language. Fine. Because they belong to Armenia, their language is Armenian. The people of Punjab speaks Punjabi. Similarly, people of Armenia speak Armenian. So it's a horse. You are not dreaming. Make it quick if you want to ride. So Murad was very, you know, particular about, he was clear about his horse. He said, why are you rubbing your eyes? Come on, it's a horse only. Jump out, come with me. Let's have a quick ride. Now we are on page number 2. I knew my cousin Murad enjoyed being alive more than anybody else who had ever fallen into the world by mistake. But this was more than I could believe. So what does this statement mean? First, we try to understand. Aram is saying, who is telling you this story? Who is narrating the story to you? Aram, fine. Aram is using the word I, na, that I was 9 and my cousin came. So narrator has, you know, made Aram his mouthpiece. There are 2 ways of telling the story. One is narrator himself narrates the story. Second is he chooses one of the characters as his mouthpiece. Clear? So who is the mouthpiece of narrator here? Aram. So Aram is telling the story to all of us. I knew my cousin Murad enjoyed being alive more than anybody else. I mean, some people, they take birth and they start, you know, living the, just for the sake of living only. But Murad was a kind of lively persona, you must say. Very lively, full of life, always want to make the best of every moment. You know, some people just keep on, kya hai, in that way, why I'm living, and boring life, and, you know, finding negativity in everything. And just following the rigid system of the society, being good always. Murad was opposite of this thing. He was lively and he wanted to make moment, you can see, wanted to live every moment of his life. So he wanted to be alive in real sense. And he says, in the first place, my earliest memories had been memories of horses. And my first longings had been longings to ride. Longings means desires, wishes. So now Aram is telling about his own preferences. Aram is saying, I love horses. And Murad knew it. Murad ko pata tha that my cousin loves horses since childhood. You know, everybody has one or the other passion. Some people, they love toys. Some people love animals. Some children love collecting dolls and all. So Aram loved horses since childhood. So Murad knew it that my cousin Aram, he loves horses. And that's why at early in the morning, he tapped at the window so that he can also relish it, enjoy it. In the second place, we were poor. First place, he has desire to have a horse. But the second thing, he is a poor chap. So being poor, they cannot afford to buy any horse. Is it clear? This was the part that would not permit me to believe what I saw. This was the part means what part? That they are poor because they all are poor. That's why he could not believe what he saw. What did he see, Jacqueline? He saw his cousin riding a beautiful white horse and he could not believe it because they are too poor to afford a horse. We had no money. We were poor. Our whole tribe was poverty stricken. Underline this. That most of the Gargholian people, they were poverty stricken. They were poor people. Every branch of the Gargholian family was living in the most amazing and comical poverty in the world. Nobody could understand where we ever got money enough to keep us with food in our bellies. Not even the old men of the family. Means nobody know. Nobody knows in their tribe that they could not even get sometimes food to eat. They are too poor to afford it. And even old people do not understand that why it is happening to them, that they are extremely poor. Most important of all, though we were famous for our honesty, we had been famous for honesty for something like 11 centuries. Underline this data also. How many years are there in a century?
Yes.
100 makes one century. Fine. So he's telling us that since 11 centuries, it has been running in their family that all their forefathers were very honest. That's why they have inherited the trait of honesty from them. Even when we had been the wealthiest family in what we like to think was the world, we were proud first, underline this line again. We were proud first, honest next, and after that we believed in right and wrong. What does this statement mean? Proud first. What? Why are they proud? They are proud of their honesty. They are proud that since 11 centuries, no one in their tribe has been a dishonest person or stolen anything. Whatever they are getting, they are comfortable, they are satisfied with that. So they were honest, they were proud first, honest, and then later on they think about right and wrong. None of us would take advantage of anybody in the world, let alone steal. Stealing to dur ki baat, that we cannot even think of about others anything bad. Fine? Got my point? The basic traits of Armenian tribe, Gargolian family especially, that they are very honest, they do not think bad about others, their intentions are very clear. They get meager food, but even then they never steal. Clear? Consequently, even though I could see the horse so magnificent, even though I could smell it so lovely, even though I could hear it breathing so exciting, I couldn't believe the horse had anything to do with my cousin Murad or with me or any of the members of our family. So in this paragraph, Aram is telling us that he's so fond of the horses, and particularly he's seeing the beautiful white horse. He does not see a horse. He feels a horse. He's so much into love with horses that he's seeing that even the horse breathes, I can hear it. I can smell the fragrance coming from the horse. But even now I know that this horse has nothing to do with my cousin, nothing to do with me or my family. Asleep or awake means chahe wo jaag raha hai, chahe wo dream mein bhi nahi so sakta. He's saying neither in my dreams I can imagine to have such a beautiful horse, because I knew my cousin Murad could not have bought the horse. He knew that he did not have money to buy a horse, and if he could not have bought it, what is the probability? Agar wo khareed nahi sakte to kaise aaya? He might have stolen it. So that's why Aram, he is hesitant of jumping in right over there. He was hesitant that definitely my cousin Murad, he's also crazy enough to do such thing. He thought Murad has stolen this horse. I refuse to believe he had stolen it. And even though he knows this, but even then he refused. Why he refused? Because on one hand, he knows that not a single person in their family, they have stolen. So he's thinking, ki kya main galat soch raha hun? Let's see. No member of the Gargolian family could be a thief. So this is the statement he gives to himself. Ki hamari family mein koi chori nahi kar sakta. It means if nobody can do it, Murad has also not done this. So he generalizes a conclusion out of it. Clear? I stared first at my cousin and then at the horse. There was a pious stillness and humor in each of them, which on the one hand delighted me, on the other frightened me. So firstly he looked at his cousin, then he looked at the horse, and then he thought that he was so excited, he was so happy, delighted to see the horse. But on the other hand, he was very scared also. Why he was scared and frightened? Hanji bhaiya, book leni hai, that I will send you. ये वाली पढ़िए, देखना यही वाली थी, फुटप्रिंट्स विदाउट फीट, यही है, दूसरी थी. आई विल सेंड यू लेटर, कोई बात मैं दे जाऊं. सो देन व्हाट हैपेंड, इट वाज ट्रू, देन ही हैड स्टोलन द हॉर्स, देयर वाज नो क्वेश्चन अबाउट इट. He had come to invite me to ride or not as I chose. So Murad, where did you steal this horse? This was the question asked by Aram. Aram asked his cousin. He did not say, where did you get this horse? He used the word steal. Where did you steal this horse? And Murad did not answer to his question. What was the reaction? He says, jump out of the window if you want to ride. He does not say. What does that show? It shows that he has stolen. That's why he is not answering to this question. He had come to invite me to ride or not as I chose. Well, it seemed to me stealing a horse for a ride was not the same thing as stealing something else, such as money. So now, jo chote bachche hote hain, beta, they are too young to, you know, suppress their emotions. If they want a thing, they will anyhow, by all means, they want that thing. Fine? So similarly, Aram is also just 9-year-old boy and he loves horses. And, you know, and his cousin is giving him a chance to ride along with him. So he, you know, gives one explanation to himself. He says, agar paise churata, to that might have been stealing. Usne horse churaya hai. This is not a stealing. And even after riding, he might be giving back to the owner. So ye stealing nahi hui. I should also join him. So that was the, do you think this is right? Right or wrong, Sahaj? Yes. This is wrong. Yes, he is actually giving excuses to himself. He also having the same desire. Ye nahi hota ki samne wala galat kar raha hai, that if, even if you want to do this, fine, in heart of hearts, but when this is wrong, that is wrong only. So Murad has stolen the horse, he is riding it, but Aram got, you know, he got away with the situation. He got carried away with the situation. He says, okay, this is not stealing. It is not money. It is it's just a horse. And after riding, we will give back to the owner. If you were crazy about the horses, the way my cousin Murad and I were, it was not stealing. So this is the explanation he gives, that we both are crazy about horses. So it is not stealing. It wouldn't become stealing until we offered to sell the horse, which of course I knew we would never do. He says, hum kaun sa bechne ja rahe hain? We are not going to sell the horse off. After riding, we will give back. We are not sell it off. We will not earn money. So this is not stealing. Let me put on some clothes, I said. So he agreed to the invitation. He accepted. He leaped into my clothes. I jumped down the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse behind my cousin Murad. So both of them joined that wrong act. And you know, since 11 centuries, 1100 years, nobody has stolen in their family. Bhookhe mar jayenge, but wo kabhi chori nahi kare. Fine, whether it is an act of stealing for eating or anything, they are known for their honesty. Fine, people used to give examples of Gargolian tribe. That see, that tribe has never done anything dishonest. They have never done any act of stealing. So these boys, they forgot about it and they got carried away with it. Yes, children? Is it clear to all of you? 15 students are there. Gursimran, Ramanjeet, Anjali. Those who are sending me feedback, I'm naming them. Khyati is there. Divnur Kaur, Mitali, Harman, Raghav, Diljeet, Ishnur. What about Prabdeep Kaur and Japanpreet? Diljeet also. Yes, Prabdeep and Japanpreet, are you there? Yes, okay. So all of you are listening. Very good. Fine. All clear to all of you? Let me just continue. Yes, better. So now, he joined his cousin. I jumped down to the yard from the window and leaped up onto the horse behind my cousin Murad. That year, we lived at the edge of town on Walnut Avenue. Behind our house was the country, vineyards, orchards, irrigation ditches, country roads. In less than 3 minutes, we were on Olive Avenue. And then the horse began to trot. Trotting is that movement of the horse. So they... at the back of their house, they were having big ditches, vineyards, creepers, beautiful surroundings where they can ride the horse, fine? So within 3 minutes, they reached the Olive Avenue where they started riding the horse properly. The air was new and lovely to breathe. When aap batao, when you get something which is very favorite of yours, which is very close to your hearts, you get a gift on your birthday and you wished for it since many years, and you become so happy that everything, when we are happy, what happens? Everything becomes, you know, happy thing for us. We start enjoying the company of our friends. We start merrymaking. Khana bhi khush hoke khayenge, aapki bekar si favorite sabji bhi nahi. Even then you will start eating that. You know, when you are happy, everything becomes, the environment becomes happier. Why? Happiness is here only, in your mind. If your mind is giving you signals that you are happy, everything you start perceiving happily. And what happens when we are sad? When our mood is not good, we don't want to listen to anyone. We don't want to listen to the teacher's lecture. We don't want to listen to, we don't want to attend any class. Fine, when we are not. So everything, your behavior is directly connected with your thoughts or your mood. Fine. So we react as per our mood is. So he, you know, that day, Aram and Murad were very happy riding on the horse, dream come true. And lovely air, the feel of the horse running was wonderful. My cousin Murad, who was considered one of the craziest members of our family, began to sing. He started singing songs. Who is singing songs? Murad. Underline this line again, very important, that my cousin Murad was considered one of the craziest members of the family. Crazy means those who have some madness in them. पता होता है ना अपने घर में बच्चे का कि ही इज लाइक दैट ओनली. सो एवरीबडी नोज दैट इन गर्गोलियन ट्राइब मुराद वाज कंसीडर्ड फ्रीक मैड बिट ऑफ क्रेजीनेस वाज देयर. शुरू से उसमें कुछ था अजीब सा. ही स्टार्टेड सिंगिंग एंजॉयिंग एंड राइडिंग द हॉर्स. आई मीन ही बिगैन टू रोर एंड इट वाज नॉट सिंगिंग. ही वाज सो हैप्पी व्हाइल राइडिंग द हॉर्स दैट ही वाज रोरिंग ओनली. हिज वॉइस वाज क्वाइट हार्श. Every family has a crazy streak in it somewhere. And my cousin Murad has considered the natural descendant of the crazy streak in our tribe. Before him was our uncle Khusro. Now comes this uncle Khusro. You might have heard your parents saying ki, aap mere jaise nahi ho. You're not like your mother. You're not like your father. You're like your grandfather. Or you're like your bua. You are like your mamu. In that way, sometimes they start associating some traits, but whatever heredity you have inherited, whatever traits you have captured from your family, that is inborn. So there is one or the other person in the family from whom you have inherited those traits, fine, biologically, and sometimes behavioral traits are also there, fine. How our behavior is formed, anybody can tell me? Psychological phenomena of formation of behavior, two things are there. One is heredity, second is environment. Fine. Heredity is you are inborn the way you are, nobody can steal it from you. You have inborn talent, you have inborn IQ level, fine, in that way. But environment can give boost to your inborn talent. If you will be getting environment of learning in your family, they are encouraging you, always praising you. Means not always praising, sometimes scolding you also required, but giving you positive feedback. So you will be growing in your family. So this is the way our behavior is formed. Clear? But you have some traits are inherited. Nobody can do anything about it. Kuch bachcho ko bahut gussa aata hai without any reason. But maybe somebody is there in the family, short-tempered. Maybe the child was treated like that in the family. That's why he's like that. So Uncle Khusro in the Gargolian tribe, he was known for one of the crazy person. Why? Because he was a person with odd behavior. And he had pet dialogues. ठीक है? जिसको हम तकिया कलाम बोलते हैं. That what are your pet words? He used to use same words all the time. That shows that he was very careless and reckless attitude he was having. Whatever was happening, he never bothered. He never bothered about the situation. So every family has a crazy streak. In this family, who was considered crazy? Uncle Khusro. Now, underline the personality or character sketch of Uncle Khusro. He was an enormous man. Enormous means big, huge. Physically, bahut bada tha. With a powerful head of black hair and the largest mustache in the San Joaquin Valley, means outdoor valley of California. He was considered one of the, you can say, very huge in structure, monster like of personality he was having. And he never talked, he roared only. वो बात नहीं करता था, चिल्लाता ही था सिर्फ. So that kind of personality he was having. So we'll continue tomorrow. Have a nice day, bitte.